Okay, let's do this. Right, first ever video. Let's see how this goes. Video. Hello, I'm Caroline. I was going to do an unbagging slash boxing today. Through the post, I received a new changing bag which I purchased from John Lewis. This is the Babymel London company bag. I think the actual bag itself is called the Robyn. I have two small children. I have a 3-year-old and a 1-year-old. Only one of them's in nappies, one is totally potty trained, but I'm still carrying around sippy cups, nappies, spare knickers just in case, all that type of malarkey. And I'm currently using this bag, which I got off Amazon. It says it's a land bag. I would hesitate to say that perhaps it might not be a genuine one. The stitching is now going at the back. The little insulated pockets in the front here have started to break. In general, it's a great bag. It's got loads of room, but it is getting a bit tatty. And I'm also finding the fact that it has so much room is that I'm putting so much in it, and that's not doing my back any good lugging around two children as well. So I can do a what's in my bag maybe soon, maybe that could be the next video. But I thought what I'd do is just unbag this one and have a look. I'm hoping that it's going to be a similar type of size, maybe smaller, and also a bit smarter. So this one I think is a faux leather. So let's see if we can open it up. I'm armed with scissors. Invoice off. Push up. Lots of packaging. Okay. Okay. Initially, it looks big, but that's because it's flat. All the little bits and pieces attached to it. Let's see if we can bulk this out by where's the zip? Unzipping it. There we go. Okay, lots of stuff inside. Okay, so it comes with an insulated bottle bag thingy. I'm not really using these that much anymore, but I do occasionally still take a bottle out just in case. I think it should come with a changing mat. Okay, cardboard. And a changing mat in here, there we go. And it also comes with a changing mat that folds out. I believe that this is washable, yes it is, machine washable, which would be handy for any accidents. I do still quite like to put one of these down on changing mats when I'm out and about, or changing tables, because they can be a bit grotty and grubby. So it's nice to know that my son can lay on one of these and that I can then just stick it in the wash if I need to. Okay, so let's see. Alright, so it has a front pocket. This is quite a stiff front opening. I thought it might be a bit softer, but that still doesn't matter. And it's just one big empty pocket. Okay, so I probably don't want to overfill that to make the bag too heavy. It's a little magnetic closure. This is what I really wanted, which is a bit sad, isn't it? But I wanted to make sure, because I have two children and I do like to take water out for them, they both drink like fishes, is that there was enough space to put their sippy cups in the side, and there is a pocket on either side. I guess the one thing that's very different from my previous bag is my previous bag was elasticated here, so I knew that if I leant forward with a bag on my back, the cup wouldn't fall out. With this, we'll have to test it and trial it and see how it goes, but it does feel like the cups that I have would probably go quite snug in there, so they should stay quite secure, but again, we'll have to try it out. On the inside, what have we got? Okay, so I don't know how you can see. On the inside here, we've got two elasticated pockets. I'm sure that will be useful for multiple things. I guess you could put nappies and wipes, that's what it shows on the picture on the bag that is in there. But I'll have to empty out my bag and see how I exactly want to arrange it. It looks like there's one zip section here, which is a shallow pocket with a bit of plastic in it. And then there is on this side, I don't know if you see in there, one big loose pocket with a little bit of Velcro. Again, not too sure what to do with those yet. But nice, decent sized bag. If I try and bulk it out and hold it up and get that tag off it. It is a nice faux leather. In general, it is soft. As I say, this front pocket, this bit is quite structured, so that's good. Maybe it means that the edges won't roll up as would do with lots of leather bags. That should hopefully hold that structure in place. Two pockets there. It has soft grab handles at the top. And what I thought was interesting, and again, we'll see how it works out, is on the back there is a backpack, so I need to untie these bits here. So you can put it over your shoulders, but then oddly enough, you can also then, when it's at full capacity, pull this strap up, oh there we go, like so, and you can pop it over your shoulder if you wanted to. I can see where there's instances where the children are mucking about maybe a little bit, and I haven't got a chance to throw it on my back, I can just grab it and throw it over my shoulder. I do have quite a lightweight buggy slash stroller, but if we're out for a day, I don't like to have the bag on my back all day. It is too much, and I do like to attach it. And it does have these little grippy things here that you can pull through, wrap around your handlebars, and then push it through and stick it down so it will then hang off those two straps there. So I do quite like that idea. In general though, initial unboxing is good. It's an attractive bag. It is a lot smarter than my previous bag. It is around about holding up against each other. It is around about the same kind of size as my previous one, which is good. There are less pockets. This has a lot more pockets, but this has less. And for me, that's going to be a good thing, because hopefully it means I'll put a lot less stuff in the bag, which will be easier on my back. And encourage me to maybe be a little bit more concise about what it is I'm packing. Thanks again for watching my unboxing. I'm very excited to pack this up. What I might do is film another video right now of me packing it, and so you can see exactly what's in there. So again, my first video, if you've watched this, please put a thumbs up and let me know. I'm sorry if I've said a lot. I will try and stop that for next videos. It's just habit of having no adult conversations right now and being with children a lot. I have to think about things and remember even what my name is most of the time. But thanks again for watching. I'm going to pack this up right now and film that too, and I look forward to seeing you again. Thanks.